And welcome to the TI Precision Lab video discussing the fundamentals of humidity sensing accuracy. In this video, we'll discuss the important sensor parameters that can impact overall system accuracy specifications. When considering datasheet specifications, it is important to take into account the three main components of relative humidity sensor accuracy. All of these must be examined to determine a sensor's total relative humidity accuracy. These components are time zero accuracy, long-term drift, and hysteresis. Time zero accuracy refers to the relative humidity accuracy after calibration at a TI factory, before the device manufacturer ships out the humidity sensor. Positive and negative accuracy curves can be seen here, with time zero accuracy determined during the production test process. The effect of long-term drift on a humidity sensor's accuracy is also seen in this graph as the relative humidity accuracy deviates each year from the time zero value. As the sensor lifetime increases, as seen on the x-axis, the long-term drift begins to affect the initial time zero accuracy. Long-term drift is specified in data sheets as the percent relative humidity drift per year over the lifetime of the part. This lifetime drift assumes normal operating conditions and is not associated with drifts due to harsh environments or contaminants. Hysteresis is specified in datasheets as the difference between relative humidity measurements in an environment where the relative humidity is rising and falling around a specific set point. Most devices will have a typical offset value associated with hysteresis that the user can take into account when quantifying overall system accuracy. In general, hysteresis values are used to specify the maximum difference between pairs of data. This is not a single value and will be different depending on if the humidity is swept up or down. The graph here shows relative humidity measurements in a chamber that is ramped from approximately 10% relative humidity to 90% relative humidity. This is an extreme humidity range for most applications, and users who have a more limited range may see less hysteresis. There are natural fluctuations in relative humidity as the chamber settles. Hysteresis refers to the differences between adjacent measurement points. This graph illustrates how long-term drift and hysteresis add on to the time zero accuracy as the lifetime of the part increases. A sensor's overall humidity accuracy is a combination of maximum percentage error, hysteresis, and long-term drift per year. Some datasheets will specify a maximum percentage relative humidity that includes hysteresis, while others will leave it as two separate values. However, it is important to understand the individual components of system accuracy. This worst-case accuracy applies to the HTC 3X family of relative humidity sensors. Many humidity sensors are in open cavity packages where the sensing polymer is exposed directly to the ambient air. As a result, humidity sensors should not be exposed to volatile chemicals, such as solvents or other inorganic compounds. Exposure to certain chemicals can cause the humidity output readings to drift, which may be irreversible. The opening in the package allows the sensor to sense the relative humidity in the air, but also exposes the polymer to the environment, making it sensitive to pollutants. Typical ambient conditions do not present a significant risk for chemical exposure, but manufacturing and storage environments are a known source of volatile contamination. During assembly, a piece of Kapton tape can be placed over the sensor opening to ensure that the device is not exposed to harmful chemicals. A permanent hydrophobic filter is a good option if the sensor will be exposed to dust, debris, or condensation during application. The following graph shows the shift in the percent relative humidity error of a humidity sensor after exposure to certain chemicals. For this testing, 5 drops of each chemical was dropped directly on the sensor opening. The post-test results show a small negative gain that was introduced after chemical exposure. This graph illustrates the effect of chemical contamination on a humidity sensor. In year 2, the sensor was exposed to a contamination event, which can add much more relative humidity error than a device would generally accumulate over a 10-year lifetime. The effect of contamination is added to the normal effects of long-term drift so that the sensor lifetime accuracy from time zero can be appropriately represented. The following is a full list of chemicals that may cause the humidity output readings of the HTC 3020 to shift. Long-term drift is specified in humidity sensor data sheets as the maximum percent relative humidity per year that a sensor will drift in normal operating conditions. If the sensor has an offset correction register, this can be programmed to mitigate drift across the lifetime of the device. Hysteresis should be accounted for in time zero accuracy and is calculated as the delta between the percent relative humidity accuracy during positive and negative humidity sweeps. To prevent contamination of an open cavity sensor, Kapton tape can be placed over the sensor opening during the assembly process. This tape will need to be removed before operation. A sensor that has a permanent filter installed can be a good option for applications that require more robustness during device operation. To conclude, there are several main components of a humidity sensor datasheet accuracy specification. The long-term drift is usually defined in the datasheet as a percent relative humidity per year, but this assumes normal lifetime conditions. Hysteresis is also defined in most datasheets and causes the accuracy to have an offset that is dependent on the previous relative humidity reading. Chemical exposure cannot be defined in datasheet limits, but the sensing polymer can experience permanent positive or negative percent relative humidity shifts if exposed to chemicals during manufacturing or assembly. And it is important to take the necessary precautions when using an open cavity humidity sensor. Thank you for watching.